them to the crack house. Bring them to the crack house. Show them the crack house. Take them to the crack house. We in the crack house. Bring them to the crack house. It's the crack house. Welcome to the crack house. We in the crack house.
Crack house, this is the crack house. What's poppin', fiends? You up in the building with your favorite white guy? Business is in the building, and we're here till midnight. I gotta shout out my other white boy in the building, Adam Bond's in the building.
Yeah.
Course, and of course, man of the hour Friday's in the building.
White power.
Straight up, he's repping it.
What up? It's Friday, aka Ricky Dredd, aka 1000 Blunts to the Head, aka the King on King, aka. Engineer Rick. That's the new one.
Engineer Rick. Okay. So you like add one every couple months?
People come up the streets and give me AKAs. You know what I mean? I got to pick my man Theo. He gave me the Friday, AKA the Bluetooth Assassin.
Real. You guys got to be one of the most consistent camps when it comes to actually putting out product.
Hey, we're working, man. We dropped about 4 CDs like in the last quarter. We came out with a SARS 5, you know, Summertime. I mean, Fifth Symptom, which featured a lot of drops from my man Adam Bomb.
Yes, sir.
My boy Buns, he dropped
Rap,
Above the Rim. Yeah. You know what I mean? To go in the theme of the Above the Rim movie, you know what I'm saying? Because he does the basketball thing over at ASU, and you know, and he does the rapping thing, you know what I mean? So he's a multitasker also, you feel me?
Correct.
And then we did the Trader Rhyme Animal. He dropped Hoodie Season. Yes, he did the Cross Canada run of it first. And just recently, we put it out in Canada over here. I mean, in Toronto over here. So,
how are you guys able? What's the secret behind the strategy behind being able to get that reach solid on every project that gets out?
It's a combination of, you know, I'm behind a computer constantly. You know, I got a stupid, crazy long MSN list. Right, so I'm always pumping the DJs when it comes to material, you know what I mean? So at least we can get the college radios across the country running stuff. But then we got people like Trader Rhyme Animal Dog that he just goes across Canada and he just goes hard at it and he sells CDs, dog. And he gets CDs in everybody's hand and he'll come back and be like, well, I just sold about 2,500 CDs on the road, you know what I mean? And then go back on the road the next few months and do it again, you know what I mean? Like he recently went from Halifax, did Halifax and a few places, and came back to Ontario, did Thunder Bay, a whole bunch of places out there, you know what I'm saying? Then went west, did Calgary, Winnipeg, and he stopped, he did Edmonton also, and he stopped at Calgary, you know what I mean? And had to come back because it was like weather issues.
Yeah.
But he constantly doing that.
And that puts the recognition out there coast to coast, so that whenever you do see that official video drop, you're going to see that the E logo on the video, and it's going to hit you that, hey, I think I got a CD from that. From either a year ago or this year or last year, and you might have 10 or 12 CDs to trail back and find 100 of the same people and 2,000 of new people to just pick up another CD, you know? So it's a combination of the hustle inside the city and outside the city that builds it.
Obviously, Empire has a storied history at Project Bounce and involved with Project Bounce.
Yes,
now,
sir.
All along, it's been established at the crack house. They have nothing but love for Project Bounce. And, you know, they broke through a path that we needed for a very long time.
Very true.
Now, obviously, Project Bounce is not with us right now.
Nah.
How does that impact you guys as far as the history and the memories you guys have of Project Bounce?
I was there on that, doing the guilty party about, I don't know, must have been 2 years ago, just having my own show and just did that little thing for a while. And now, that's a medium for not just ourselves, not just myself, but anybody who's a struggling artist, anybody who is an artist that wants to get out to a whole other generation of people, because we have a couple set mediums here. We got Crack House here, we got Flo here, we got 88.1, we got all the college radio stations across the coast, you know what I mean? And they do their things, and without them, a lot of music wouldn't be heard. Project Bounce is a big medium, you know what I mean? Everybody had their ups and downs with the station. Certain people couldn't get in, some people weren't getting the love that they're supposed to, but at the same time, they gave love to people that they didn't have to give love to. In the same way that every other show we got coming out right now, they don't have to spin the music. Promoters don't have to put on the shows, but people are doing it because they love hip-hop, and that, you know, it's a recipe to another good thing that died, you know what I mean? Hopefully that stuff comes back, and hopefully anybody that puts out good rap music comes back in the city and puts it on. It's a hindrance still.
You see, what a loss, what it came from that is the fact that it was on every day.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Because we have enough radio shows in Toronto especially, you know, because I've gone across Canada to different places, and like there'll be one, two college radio shows in each different place, where Toronto will have like 12 of them, you know what I'm saying? But you have to listen on each different days of the week to be able to hear them, you know what I mean? Where Project Bounce, you just turn it on every day and it's on, right? So, but the only thing that changes is you just gotta work a little harder, you know what I mean? You gotta be up on all the radio stations, which we were already doing anyway. You know what I mean? True. Because I think a lot of people were ignoring the fact that there was other college stations in the daytime. They don't want to get no clean versions of nothing. You know what I mean? So it's like, all right, well, I'll just meet up Project Bounce all the time. But you ask them, hey, have you ever gone to a static show? And they'll be like, what the hell is that? They're like, no, the one that's at 5 o'clock. Are you up at that time? Because there's a lot of people up all over the clock. You know what I'm saying? So it's all going to be feeding the people every time.
Rest in peace, Project Bounce and the Guilty Party.
Definitely. Now, I want to get him back to the mixtapes for a second. For a second here, what is the process from, you know, start to finish of a typical Empire AWOL release?
Okay, well, when it comes to me personally, when I came out with this last CD, I'm an animal when it comes to the booth. When I get my mind focused on, okay, I'm going to drop a mix CD, I'll go in the booth like every day for the next 2 weeks and cut 2-3 tracks until I like have a 20-something songs and I'm like, all right, I'm taking these 18, the hottest ones.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Now, what about once you get the creative side dealt with, then where do you go from there?
I get with Law, because Law puts all the mixes down for all our mixtapes. You know what I'm saying? I send him the tracks. Like, I always have a little idea of what the song order is going to be. And I'll have that version of the CD in my car, and I'm bumping that all the time. But then when I send it to Law, and he does his mix, I'm always interested to see what order he puts the songs in. You know what I mean? Send it over, you know, Trey hosts a mixtape, we get it pressed up, and we're good to go.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
And then from there, it's contacting your MSN list.
Contacting the MSN list, and I hit the stores. Like, that's my thing. I do the distribution as far as the stores go. So I'll go in town and out of town and make sure the stores are supplied. You know what I'm saying? And trade starts murdering the streets.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? And then I take orders off of Hip Hop Canada. I take orders off my Hotmail and all that too. Mm-hmm. So it's all good.
So it's all outlets, and it's not really like no magical wand that pushes it out there. It's a lot of real.
I just drive to the spot. I have three spots that I prefer to go to. You know, at first I used to go and put mixtapes in like every store all over the city. But what ends up happening is not every store is gonna sell your mixtape. Like, it'll sit there on the shelf, and then you just run out of product, and you don't even know where half your product is. You can't even collect back the money, even if it was made.
Right.
So I focus on, like, Play the Record, which is like a stable over here, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And Mixtape Massacres, you know what I'm saying? I mess with them cats, and CSAs. Mm-hmm. Hit them three places up, and then I do my out-of-town runs. You know what I'm saying? Right.
This isn't necessarily a question to you. If Scandalous was here, I would ask Scandalous. But since he's not, I'm going to ask you guys about your idea behind this, is that one of the things that I got out of that interview was a real sense of frustration, and almost like, not necessarily in the situation with Scars, but he put forth a tone and some language that I felt maybe lent itself to the position that Scandalous, or maybe some people in Empire, maybe feeling like, shit, like, we've been doing this for a very long time now, and maybe the legs were running out. Like,
a lot of times Scandalous could give a fuck less about rap music, a lot of times, and he's one of the nicest cats I've ever seen rock a mic, so for him to throw it in burns the hell out of the camp. But at the same time, we all understand, because sometimes your mind tells you to do other things, and really, if it wasn't for his heart coming back and telling him, hey, you do this rap shit well, you better come back hard, we wouldn't see him now. So take it as a blessing that you're going to see him on a new album. Take it as a blessing that you're going to see all of us on a new album.
Talking about coming back hard, I want to know, because I was promised that when it dropped, it would come here. What the fuck is good with Canada Sucks third verse?
It's out. I have it written. It is done, finished, written. It's never been recorded. Okay. Nobody other than myself knows who the hell that verse is about. I know who it's about, and you should know who it's about. But at the same time, you guys do have the rights. I had Project Bounce asking me, hey, are you not going to drop it here first or not? Right. Crack House? I was like, oh, man, I'm going to have to decide it. No, I don't even have to make a decision. It's on Crack House first when it drops. Reason why it hasn't come out, first of all, it hasn't had an opportunity to. Second of all, I don't want to follow up a controversial Let Me Drop Some Names record with another Drop Your Name verse. Because if all I have to show over this whole time since I dropped that is another verse from that record, I'm really not doing enough music. So I'd rather hit y'all with some new product. And when the time comes where that person comes out of his face, I would drop that third verse. No questions about it. And it's here on the Crack House when it is.
Is there
a word?
Is there?